What if Komodo dragons were introduced into the Amazonian rainforest? Imagine a monster entering a jungle, one that doesn't belong. A beast from a faraway island, now stalking the heart of the Amazon. This jungle has seen many creatures in its time, but never this particular one. He's not even from this continent. The Komodo dragon. So, what would happen if the Komodo dragon invaded South America and found his way to the Amazon? Don't get too close to the Komodo. Climb a tree, sit on a branch, subscribe to the channel for updates, and watch from a safe distance, if such a thing even exists. The Komodo Dragon. Before entering the Amazonian rainforest, we have to travel a great distance to find the origins of the one living dragon on Earth. It's such a great distance. Starting at the Amazon, you could go east or west. It doesn't matter much. You'll likely be traveling over 10,000 miles either way. But eventually, we'll reach southeastern Indonesia, home of the Komodo dragon. But this rare beast lives on only a select few islands. 5 islands, to be exact. The islands of Flores, Rinca, Gilimantang, Gili Desami, and of course, Komodo. The Komodo dragon is the largest living lizard on the planet. The females can be 7.5 feet long and 160 pounds, and the males can be 8.5 feet long and 200 pounds. There are other long lizards in the world that come fairly close to the length of the Komodo dragon, but none have the girth. The second heaviest lizard after the Komodo is roughly 1/4 the weight. The Komodo dwarfs the rest of them in this respect, really earning his dragon status. This monster may not breathe fire, but you'd be smart to stay as far away from that mouth as possible. The Komodo has zifferent teeth, laterally flattened, recurved, and serrated. If teeth serrated like a Ginsu knife isn't already frightening, know this. Those are the same type of teeth observed in theropod dinosaurs, like Allosaurus, Spinosaurus, or the T-Rex. Is the Komodo a dragon or the last living dinosaur? In addition to those deadly teeth, the Komodo dragon also has venomous glands in its jaw. So this dragon doesn't breathe fire, he just spews venom. A Komodo's bite force is typically between 500 to 600 psi, which isn't nothing, but also not devastating. So his method is to bite into his prey with those serrated teeth, stabbing deep into the flesh, injecting the venom, and then using his pull-back method. They dig their 2-inch long claws into their prey and hold them still while they pull back with their head, ripping the flesh and continually doing so, using their strong neck muscles to yank at their prey and shred them apart. It's a horrible fate for the prey of a Komodo to endure. Some animals escape the clutches of the Komodo only to later collapse from their injuries, and the Komodo will go back to find the unfortunate soul who he has dubbed Dinner. This vicious dragon is the ruler of his land, the largest predator around. He is the apex predator, the merciless king, subjecting his subjects to horrid death. He'll eat almost anything, whether it be carrion or an animal that he hunts down himself. They'll eat lizards, birds, and most popularly, go after large mammals like deer, pigs, and even enormous water buffalo. Don't find yourself on the island of Komodo if you want to remain safe. But if you do, avoid the dragon at all costs. You may not see him at first, he may be lurking, hidden in the bushes, but once he sees his prey, he ambushes. The ruthless beast will go for the throat or the underbelly and slash into the unwitting soul. Some kills only take a matter of seconds. He is, by all accounts, the lord of southeastern Indonesia. But would this lord rule on high in another land? The Amazon. The Amazonian rainforest is known as one of the most diverse places on Earth, but it is also one of the most dangerous. There is no shortage of bloodthirsty predators here, and there is no shortage of blood to go around. The Amazon is located in South America, spanning several countries like Brazil, Venezuela, Colombia, and more. This rainforest is made up of more than 40,000 plant species. The thick canopy above locks in the moisture, and though it is home, it does not lock in the 1,300 species of birds in this area, 427 different mammal species, 400 different amphibian species, and 378 reptile species. Many of these animals feast on the 40,000 plant species, but there are plenty that are not satiated by plants. They need meat. The bone-chilling screech tearing across the sky comes from the harpy eagle, the most powerful eagle alive. His talons are as thick as a human's arm. And not only are small birds and rodents worried about this winged predator, even monkeys can be carried off to meet their demise. Smaller animals also have to worry about the Amazon tree boa crawling on the branches, waiting to pick them off in a flash. It may be best to stay off the trees, duck down, and keep your eyes on the skies. But dipping into the water is a bad idea as well. If the piranhas don't eat you alive, if the electric eel doesn't jolt you, there can be bull sharks in these fresh waters. But worse, and more common, the black caiman. 17 feet long, 1,000 pounds, this reptile is enormous. He loves the water and moves through with deadly agility, but he can move swiftly on the land too. A bite from his jaws would devastate you with power, and those 72 teeth bring the darkness in quicker than you could imagine. So maybe you'd avoid getting too close to the water, stay inland as best as you could. Most people won't fear the Amazon tree boa because he's too small to cause damage to a human, but he's far from the largest snake here. One of the largest snakes in the world, and in fact the heaviest, the green anaconda lives here. 20 feet long, over 500 pounds, wrapping around you, restricting, suffocating. It's a slow and painful way to meet your maker. A quicker route may be to come across another apex predator of the Amazon, the jaguar. The third largest feline in the world, but with the strongest bite of all the cats. 1500 PSI, he can crack through a turtle shell with those jaws. Over 6 feet long, over 300 pounds of fast twitch muscle, the ability to hit speeds of 50 miles per hour in a flash. You're not overpowering the jaguar, you're not outrunning the jaguar. Let's face it, if you come across a jaguar and he wants to eat you, you're not living much longer. But you're a human, you're not a Komodo dragon. Competition. There were 378 reptiles in the Amazonian rainforest. Now there are 379, because the Komodo dragons have arrived, and they're sniffing out their competition. Right now, one of our dragons has been wandering through the trees, swinging his head from side to side as they do while they walk, flicking his tongue out, smelling the air. And he's caught a hint of reptile, a large one, the green anaconda. The anaconda doesn't know what it's detecting, other than it's a threat. He's going to strike, but there is too much of him exposed at 20 feet long, and the Komodo dragon is an expert at going for vulnerable spots. The dragon leaps into action and claws into the anaconda, holding him still while he bites and tears at him. The anaconda would attempt to collapse his body around the dragon and restrict him while he attacks, but even as he would do so, the dragon would just keep biting and slashing. It wouldn't take him all that long to dismantle the anaconda. Two more of the dragons have found a water source, looking to get a drink of water, and are zeroing in on separate parts of the river when two more reptiles quickly emerge from the murky depths. A black caiman. Two of them, and they're quick. One Komodo dragon is taken by surprise, and as he attempts to fight back, the black caiman clamps down on him with thousands of pounds of force from his jaws. This reptile far outweighs him, and seeing as how he struck first, he won. But the other Komodo dragon saw the black caiman coming and avoided his initial attack, narrowly escaping the clamping of those jaws. The Komodo dragon, after quickly recoiling, leaps back into action, and the caiman cannot spin around quickly enough. He outweighs the Komodo, but he is not as agile. Once the Komodo sinks his jaws into the caiman's skin, the venom is in. The caiman would thrash and fight back, but the dragon is tearing even his tough skin apart, and within moments the caiman is sinking back into the river. Two more dragons wander through a dense part of the rainforest. They separate by a few hundred feet, but each meets the same fate. A flash of a yellowy-brown jungle cat, a jaguar. These animals are faster and more agile than anything the Komodo dragon has encountered, and one of them is pouncing on him and delivering a devastating blow with his jaws. This dragon cannot withstand the attacks. Hundreds of feet away, the other dragon is lucky to have seen the attack coming from the jaguar and delivered a counterpunch. This opponent is strong, but the dragon's claws are strong too. He is able to hold the jaguar still while he delivers vicious bite after vicious bite, secreting his venom. The jaguar doesn't weigh so much more than the dragon, so he takes several large attacks before prying himself away. He escapes for now, but soon succumbs to his wounds and collapses on the jungle floor. Diet. As delicious as the anaconda, the caiman, and the jaguar may have been to those Komodo dragons that survived, that wouldn't be their favorite meal in this new place. For one, the meals fought back with extreme power and very likely could have killed them. So it would be better to find non-predators. Back home in Indonesia, the Komodo dragon loved water buffalo, pigs, and any kind of ungulates he could get his claws on. Lucky for him, there are plenty of ungulates in the area. There are grey brocket deer and red brocket deer, so dinner doesn't get bland or repetitive. There are a couple different kinds of peccary for breakfast and lowland tapirs for lunch. All similar to the deer and pigs back home. Similar enough, anyway. He may be able to find buffalo here and there, but he might have to leave the confines of the rainforest. And of course, the jungle is replete with different monkeys and lizards and birds if the Komodo is happy with doing a lot of snacking throughout the day. And with plenty of places to hide in the jungle, the ambush tactic of the Komodo dragon will still work well. Consequences. So let's journey back to our original question. What if Komodo dragons were introduced into the Amazonian rainforest? What exactly would that look like? The Komodo dragon's food sources would change slightly, but they'd remain similar enough. He'd still have his share of ungulates to hunt and feast on. He'd just have to get used to a different flavor profile. Still, ungulates are ungulates. The Komodo has hoofed animals to eat. His tactics would still work, and he'd have no problem catching his fair share of food. The environment is fine for reptiles to live in. Obviously, he's one of nearly 400, so there's no problem there. He's already used to the warm weather. But the Komodo would have to make a major adjustment. Ask the Komodo what he is, and he'd tell you he's a dragon. An almighty dragon, ruling in high, the king of his land. Because on those southeastern Indonesian islands, the Komodo doesn't experience much competition. He is a giant on the islands he inhabits. Here in the Amazon, yes, he's still a large predator and a formidable opponent. But that's just it. He's an opponent. He is no longer the apex predator. Best case scenario, he is one of a few apex predators. Worst case scenario, he's just another predator. We saw him take out an anaconda, we saw him take out a black caiman, and we saw him handle a jaguar. However, we saw a caiman end one dragon, and saw a jaguar do the same. Living in his Indonesian islands, the Komodo dragon often thought himself invincible. But here, that is no longer the case. He can be stopped. The Komodo dragon would have to change his arrogant thinking from that of a king to that of a warrior. He could not assume he was untouchable. He needs to act with a defensive strategy in mind as well. Because the Amazon is a dangerous place. But once the Komodo dragon stepped foot into it, it just got a whole lot more dangerous. A dragon lurks there now. He may not breathe fire, but he's got a raging fire burning inside of him. You don't want to be around when he lets it out.